Good morning. This is my second video on the belt drive. Okay. In first video, I explained about the introduction of the belt drives. Today, I'll go for the that is the friction in the ratio of the friction and tension in the flat belt. Okay. I will determine the tension in the belt drives. Okay. Before that one, I will explain the what is the velocity ratio. You have to remember this one. Velocity ratio equal to we can represent as a VR. That is the ratio of the driver. That is the speed of the follower and that is the speed of the driver. It is a reciprocal of the d1 divided by d2. If you are considering the thickness, you have to take it as a t, that is the thickness of the belt. Okay, n1 and n2 are speed of the driver and driven. We can that is the n1 is the speed of the driver, n2 is the speed of the driven. We can say for the driven also, that is the follower also. d1 and d2 are the diameter of the driver and driven. T is the thickness of the belt. Then I will explain the what is the I will determine the tension in the belt for the flat belt only. Okay, before that one I will give the some nomenclature. That is the T1, that is the tension in the tight side. T2 is the tension on the slack side, that is a unit comes as a newton. Then theta is angle of the lap of the belt over the pulley. We can say that is a, you have to take it as a in the form of that is a degree. You can convert further as a radian. It is a degree presently. You can say that is a degree. Then mu is the coefficient of the friction between the belt and pulley. For the lap angle, we can say that is a one more, that is a wrap angle also. I have explained in this is a, in previous lecture also, that is a wrap angle and angle of lap. Angle of lap means that is the angle where it is a belt starting of the belt and the end of the belt with the pulley. That is a theta, the amount of the belt placed on the pulleys, that is a nothing but a lap angle. That is, I can say that is a theta. Then next nomenclature comes as a normal reaction between the element of the length of the belt and pulley. That is a R. It is a belt, it is a normal reaction between the belt and pulley. That is, we can represent as a R. T is the tension on the slack side. If you considering instead of this one, T1 is that is a tension, that is initial belt tension, T1 and T2. Okay, that is a theta. I will take it as a symmetry, small angle, that is a delta theta. Okay, that is I have taken here also, that is a schematic diagram I have written here also. Okay, before that one I will take it as a small t is that is a tension in the slack side. Delta t, that is amount of increment in the increment of the tension, that is a delta t. This is the t plus delta is the tension of the total tension of the tight side. Okay, this is the total tension on this tight side. Okay, before that one I will take it as a theta. Lap angle is theta. Instead of that is a full theta, I will take it as a small angle, that is the delta theta. Okay, I will take it as a delta theta. Then what that is the tension is a t. This is a tension is a tension in the slack side. T plus delta is the that is the tension on the tight side. R is the normal reaction between the belt and pulley. This is a one more force, that is a force of friction between the belt and pulley. That is exactly opposite. If it is a rotating clockwise, that is opposite to that one. That is a force of friction. Okay, you have to take it that one. If you are considering this is a pulley. Okay, instead of this one, I will take it as a small angle for the analysis of the forces. That is a delta theta. Instead of this is I have taken here delta theta. I have taken here only a schematically drawn here. Okay, delta theta. When you go for the symmetry, this comes as a delta theta by 2, and automatically this also comes as a delta theta by 2, delta theta by 2. Then how many forces will you find it? That is a normal reaction. This is a one force. Then force of friction will be there. T is the tension on the slack side. T plus delta T is the tension on the tight side. These are the we'll find the four forces, and you have to resolve the forces in horizontal direction and vertical direction. First, I'll go for the horizontal direction. Forces in horizontal direction means this direction, that is horizontal direction, whatever that is, horizontal direction. I will take it as a left or right. If you consider this is a symmetry, left if you are taking as a positive, right it is a negative. You take it, that is a one side is a positive, one side is a negative. That is a mu r is a force of friction. I have taken as a positive. Then this is T here. T cos delta theta is, that is also becomes a horizontal. Then t plus delta t, that is a cos delta theta becomes also horizontal. Then I will consider as a delta theta is a small, that is a once again it comes as a small means it is comes as a 1 0. Then you have to put it in this equation mu r, this becomes a 1, one whole things becomes a 1. Then finally we will get it as a equation as delta t mu r. Okay, then that is a horizontal thing. Then once again you have to resolve the forces in vertical direction. Okay, vertical direction, how many forces comes into picture? Vertical direction r will be there and t will be there, then t delta theta, these are the three forces will find in vertical direction. Okay, this is a friction force will not be there in horizontal, that is a vertical direction. How many forces? If you consider one of the direction as a positive, vertical, that is a positive, if your vertical as a positive, and downward direction if you are taking as a negative, then it comes r is a positive minus both are the, this becomes a sine theta, resolve the forces t sine delta theta, this also becomes a negative, then once again delta theta is also small, then finally it comes as a delta theta by, finally it remains as a delta theta by 2. You put it these values, then you will find it delta theta by 2, you put it, then final equation it becomes a 2, this cancels, this becomes a whole product, delta t, this is a small, I will neglect this one, you cancel it or otherwise you neglect it, you have to say this is a neglect, then finally it remains as a these two three quantity, this plus becomes 2t delta theta by 2, finally it comes as a delta t equal to mu, you replace, that is a, it comes as this equation r equal to t delta theta. Then once again this r value, you have to put it in equation this, if you considering this is equation 1, this is a 2, then r you have to put it in this delta t, you have to put it r, then finally it comes as in this way delta t equal to mu t delta theta. Then you rearrange this equation, tension you have to make it as a suppressed side, and this is a mu and delta theta, this is then we have to go for the integration, because we are taken as a small amount, that is once again in order to go for the theta, whole theta you have to integrate, that is t2 t1, t2 is a smaller, that is a tension, this is a smaller one compared to t1, because this is a slack side, t2 is a, this comes as a slack side, I will explain, I have explained here also, that is a t2 is a smaller compared to t1, that is a, this is a t1 is comes as a tight side, t1 is a tight side, t2 is a slack side minimum. Then once again when you go for the integration, finally you will get it as t1 log t1 by t2, that is a mu, this is theta, you replace, that is a theta, it comes as a mu theta. Finally you have to rearrange this equation, it comes as a t1 by t2 equal to e raised to mu theta, this is a final equation, this is a diff, that is a tension in the belt drives for the flat belt, this is for the flat belt. Then I have written as a one more equation, that is the power transmitted in the belt drive. Okay, this is a one more equation I have written as a power transmitted in the belt drive. T1 is a tension on the tight side, same nomenclature is there. T2 is also tension on the slack side, that is also, it comes as a Newton. V is a linear velocity of the belt, that is a meter per second. Then what is the power formula? That is a P equal to net force. Net force into distance moved by the per second. Net force means that is the difference between the tension T1 minus T2. We will get it as a net force. This is a velocity. That is a velocity. That is, I have taken linear velocity. It comes as a V. The final velocity, that is a power equal to, that is in the form of kilowatt or watt. Okay. These are the two formula is important. That is a T1 minus T2 into V. At the same time, this is also important, T1 by T2 e raised to mu theta. Using these formula, 1 into It is useful for the numerical solution, numerical problem. You have to remember this. Okay. I'll stop here only. Thank you.